Już jak mi z odem, już jak mi ten new apartment, I'm like them.
Hi guys, this is Music Box Exclusive, and today's guest, we have the fantastic Minelli.
Oh, thank you so much.
We're so happy to have you here.
I'm very happy to be here, and a little bit nervous, I have to recognize.
Don't worry about it. First of all, I want to congratulate you with all the success. You deserve it all. You have big fans here in Poland. And how are you doing? When was the last time you were in Poland?
Thank you so much. Thanks for the compliments. It's actually my first time in Poland. So yeah, it's my first time here. So that's why I was saying that I'm very happy to be here with you.
Yeah. That's amazing. Have you seen anything?
Did you
get the chance?
No, I didn't get a chance, but maybe today, when I finish with everything, we will go for a walk and see.
Are you gonna try any Polish cuisines?
I've tried last night, help me, like ravioli?
Pelmeni.
No.
No? Which?
Pirogi, yes. Uh-huh. Yeah.
You liked it?
Delicious, yeah. It was delicious.
Let's start with one of your biggest successes, Ram Pam Pam. We have to mention it because it is such a catchy song.
Yeah. You shot me so damn well, you rum pam pam. You shot me, then you got me, and I'm like damn, you rum pam pam. I see the satisfaction in your eyes, rum pam pam. I loved you and I trusted you so well. So why, oh why, you shot me so damn well, you rum pam pam. You shot me, then you got me, and I'm like damn, you rum pam pam.
It is still playing everywhere.
I'm happy to hear that.
Yeah. How do you feel with all the recognition you've been receiving?
Obviously, I'm very, very happy and grateful for everything that's happening right now. And, you know, I'm making music for so many years now. And to see that actually right now it's happening, what I've dreamed to happen back in the days. Mm-hmm. I'm very happy to see that the songs are well received and to see that the people relate with the messages of my songs.
Mm-hmm. Dreams come true, basically.
Yeah.
And hard work pays off.
That's the right
that's fantastic
thing to say, yeah.
And I saw in your previous interviews that you mentioned that Ram Pam Pam is about overcoming a toxic relationship.
Mm-hmm. Confusing thoughts and mystery, I see. Our love was just a fantasy for me. You play me like nobody.
Mm-hmm. When you were everything for me. Mm-hmm. What kind of message do you want your listeners to get from the song?
It's about a breakup and how to, when it gets toxic, you should leave. You should start another, not another one, because it's stupid to say that, but you should be able to move on and get on with your life. I think that's a thing you have to do when you see that relationship gets toxic.
That's definitely the message I got from the song.
And even though sometimes it's not that easy to do it.
That's for sure.
Yeah, but that's the best thing to do.
Yeah. And you're also a songwriter, that I think is very important to mention.
Yeah.
You sing and write in English. Is there a specific reason for that?
No, maybe because I love English and
love
I feel like, yeah, I feel like in English everything sounds more fluent and more musical, if I can say like that.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm singing in English.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And also, so many of us can understand what you're singing about.
Yeah, and that's another reason.
So we are happy.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah.
Also, speaking about languages, I saw there's a French version of Ram Pam Pam. How did the idea come together? Do you speak French?
I've learned a bit in school, but I think it's a hard language, and if you don't speak the language, you forget it. And I did the same thing. I know just only basic things in mm-hmm. French, but I had somebody that helped me writing the chorus in French, okay. and mm-hmm. I learned it.
Wow.
Like he said to me, you have to sing it like that, like that, like that. Then it was perfect. Yeah.
Yeah.
But I felt like the chorus sounded perfect in French. That's why we did it. Yeah, the chorus, because mm-hmm. the whole song, it was too much for me. Yeah.
Let's talk about your new release, mm-hmm. Nothing Hurts. Mm-hmm. Closure. Closure's all I need now that it's over. Amazing music video, by the way. You look amazing in it.
Yeah, thank you so much. Thanks.
Tell me, I heard that at the beginning of the music video, we can hear Ram Pam Pam playing. Mm-hmm. Is it like a continuation of Ram Pam Pam into Nothing Hurts?
Yes, because everybody's asking me, why another love song? And Nothing Hurts is another love song about a breakup, but it continues the idea of Ram Pam Pam. And I don't know, I feel like love is so important for us, and it's a feeling that takes us to so many stages. So it's the most relatable topic, and that's why I'm singing again about mm-hmm. love. Nothing hurts like you do. I knew you were bad news moment that I met you. Yeah, I know. Oh baby, nothing hurts like you do. I'm crying in the bathroom listening to sad tunes. Yeah, it's true.
And the lyrics are about overcoming. So mm-hmm. you've already overcome, yes, mm-hmm. this relationship, this breakup.
Yeah.
So
I already know that it's time for me to move on. Yeah. But I'm saying to the guy that nothing hurts like you do.
Yes.
And I would want to say some other things, but
in the next song.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Or maybe we will release another song about... I have a song, my favorite song about life. It's called Bubblegum. But we don't know, we will see.
Oh,
yeah.
That's exciting.
Yeah.
And you have three outfits in the music video.
Yes.
I think, I believe.
Yeah.
I watched it.
Yeah.
And do you have a designer? Do you have a stylist? Or do you have some brands that you love?
Yes, I have a stylist. I collaborate with a girl, Madalina, and she's taking care about all my I don't know how to say
looks.
Yeah. And which one is your favorite?
I like the bodysuit and the trench.
Listening to sad tunes. Yeah, it's true. That was...
You look fun. You know what you're doing. You're confident.
All the girls were saying at the video, like, damn, this is my favorite one.
Yes.
Yeah. I loved it.
When can we expect a new single or maybe a full EP? Is there any hint of a date or something?
Maybe. I just released Nothing Hurts, so maybe we will have another song in January or February.
Okay.
Yes, maybe
soon.
Yeah,
guys,
but I'll let you enjoy Nothing Hurts.
Yes, we love it.
Yes, baby, nothing hurts like you do. Yeah, I know. Oh baby, nothing hurts like you do.
Yeah, it's true. You have a song called Discoteca mm-hmm. with the amazing Ina. Mm-hmm. What was it like working with such a legend? No, I ain't no troublemaker. I just wanna dance like in Jamaica. Need some din din and some rum, need to wake up. And I'll be the life of the party. And I'm no troublemaker, mama, but I'm a shaker. He knows, I know, baby, you know that I got the flavors.
It was actually fun. Yeah, she's a funny girl, and we had that chemistry on when we were filming, so it was quite easy.
Fast.
And yeah.
That's
she's very funny, and
yeah,
I had a lot of fun with her.
And were you in the studio together recording, or was it like done separately at a time?
Done separately, but because I write for her too, we are in the studio together often. Mm-hmm. So
that's amazing. You also have a collaboration with DJ Sicko Toy.
Yeah.
A song called Addicted.
Yes,
amazing.
I love that
song as well.
Yeah, yeah.
What was it like working with him?
You're like a coffee, you're a drug. I'm addicted to your love. I'm
I work with Sicko Toy for many years now. It's a big producer from Romania, and I respect him a lot. Mm-hmm. And I don't know, we have a big chemistry when we are in the studio, and we actually make beautiful songs, if I can say like that. Yeah, yeah. I love working with him. Yeah, and that's why we have a lot of songs together.
Mm-hmm. It's an awesome track. So you are quite big on collaborating. Mm-hmm. Can we expect a new collaboration anytime soon?
I hope so. I have some plans, mm-hmm. but you know.
It's a surprise for us.
Yes, yes, okay. It's a surprise, yeah.
I also noticed that you co-write a lot with Vicky Red.
Mm-hmm.
What does your writing process look like?
Actually, Ram Pam Pam was wrote, yes.
Also Party, right? Your song called Party?
Yeah, I did Party with him too, as a producer, because he is a producer.
Mm-hmm.
I've worked with him for so many years now, so I have some producers in Romania that I love working with, and the process of Ram Pam Pam was, I don't know, I had to go to the studio to have a session for myself for a new single. And he said to me that he has a bombastic beat, and he showed it to me. And I said, okay, let's take some minutes to work on it and see if it's inspiring me. And I got the idea of Ram Pam Pam. And after that, I had the chorus. And I wrote the verses, and that was the song.
Was it a fast writing process?
Yes,
with this one,
I think it was pure inspiration. Yeah,
it was meant to be.
Yeah, I think so. And it was very fast.
Do you have artists that inspire you, or any big artists that you associate yourself with?
I have lots of artists that I love. Frank Sinatra, I love his music. And the way he was on the stage every time, he was very relaxed. Aretha Franklin, John Legend, Bruno Mars. Mm-hmm. I can see him there on the walls beside me.
Yes.
Yeah. Rita Ora.
You like big vocalists.
Yeah.
You have a big voice as well.
Thanks a lot. Yeah.
We are happy to see you succeed and write amazing songs.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much for this interview.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for your time. And I wish you all the success. May you have more and more hits in the future.
Thank you so much. Thanks a lot.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you.